All right, guys, round three with the element tonight. See what we can get up or down. This is a new vertical descent that I added that's off camber. Kind of what I'm trying to simulate is a side hill on a descent. Again, the Ecto doesn't disappoint. Wow, good lord. This is quickly becoming one of my favorite and most boring vehicles. And I mean that in the best way, because wow. All right, so I stacked some rocks up, what I thought would be a pretty difficult climb. It's about as vertical as I could stack these rocks and not have them fall over. And that right, or that front left tire, if you guys can see that or not, but it's having to come on off camber on the right side with a straight up ascent on the left. So it's wanting to tilt my truck over and to the left, or it just sits here and grinds on these tires. The bottom, I tried to make sure it was something smooth, so it was not really giving my rear tires a lot to grab on. Then I put a rock right underneath where the axle would hit to try to create a bad clearance situation. So, see what it does. This might be it, guys. Nope. Excellent. It went over the side again. All right. Finally found a hard line. Good. That's kind of what I was going for here. It was something hard. And finally, found something the Ecto is challenged by.
Technically, IMAX is a virtual reality company. You can shop the lot virtually online.
I don't know if you guys can see this or not, but this edge of concrete I intentionally left on the smooth, rounded side. And it looks to be like somebody had a ring around their tree or with the concrete or something, but it's a real smooth, flat curve that has even a beveled edge, so it's really a bad edge to try to grab, with, especially with these boggers.
My car online and got
or swampers, whatever you want to call them. I guess swamper.
You know those things impact your credit score.
Well, and that rock at the axle was really creating a problem, which is what I wanted. I was kind of hoping that was going to create an issue for me. Because it hits that axle before my tires are really able to get on that concrete, so... Let's try backing up. We'll try to get that tire on the other axle and see if I can get up and over the other side of that. I think I'm gonna have to take this from the side. Come here, truck. All right. It's having a really hard time with that big rock right there. Pushed itself right back down into that corner. So I have accomplished what I wanted in that I've got a precarious spot to get up. I think if I can get this rear right. Yep, there it goes, guys. That was it. That was the line. Right up we go. So, I don't know if you can see that, but that's a from here to here is about 9 inches of empty space, and it went up it. And looks like I'm on my belly. No, that Lexan rock sound is just terrible. Oh, there it is. Right on. All right. So now we're gonna come up and over. I'm gonna try to drop my tire off in that hole right there and see how it handles it. Drop it completely in that hole. Not one bit of difference. Wow. Jeez. All right, guys. Maybe don't buy an Ecto because they're too good. Or maybe I'm just an amazing crawler tuner. Maybe I should go to competitions. I'm talking. Oh my god. Alright, guys. This is as close as I've ever come to tipping this thing. This is incredible. Alright. This truck is literally at the weirdest angle. My rear tire. I just can't get any scale. My entire hand is going underneath the rig right here. And it is completely about to roll over. I mean, there's free space all underneath here. I mean, it's just, how is this truck still on its roof? I'm about as flat as I can be with my camera, and this truck is absolutely perched on the edge of nothing. I don't know how. How is this truck still sitting there? If I can drive out of this, guys, I'm officially gonna have to call this the best rock crawling rig I've ever driven. I think it's gonna go right over on its top, but if I can get that front shock to push back under that left front, unbelievable, guys, look at that. Drop right down. You know, these Desert Lizard shocks are really good. I'm running 90 millimeters, soft on top, soft on bottom, and 25 weight oil. So, or 35, I'm running 35. And I would have thought for sure that would have gone over. I can't believe this truck did not let out right there. Unbelievable. I don't know if you could, I don't know if I jerked my camera or not, but I lurched from my truck to catch it and it didn't fall. So try to get really close so you guys can. Loving it. Found that sticker and I had to have it, guys. All those idiots running to the store for toilet paper. I got a whole backyard full of leaves on my trees. Toilet paper was not my primary concern in the midst of COVID. I actually saw a guy, if you're familiar with the Come and Take It Gonzalez flag, he had a Come and Take It sticker with a roll of TP instead of a, or no, it's the Gadsden flag. He had a Come and Take It with a roll of TP instead of the snake. It was pretty cool. Made me laugh. All right, we're gonna come across the top, down the ladder bridge, and I'm gonna try to go up another spot I thought would be hard for the truck. It's just a big rock on a plateau that's pretty much straight up, but I don't know. And see, guys, the Ecto just, I don't even have to get off my gas or try to ease it down that bridge. This truck just doesn't do anything like my CFX and my Capra that just wants to pitch forward there every time, and that's probably lack of tuning on my part because it's probably closer to a 70-30 weight distribution versus a 60-40 like this one, which I know 60-40 is kind of the go-to. Let's see, I don't know if you can tell or not, but this particular rock has an overhang on it, which is taller than the tire, so it's gonna have to go in to that groove here and up and over. So that's why I thought, I don't know if you guys can see that or not, but this is stuck in that groove right there. So, I mean, your front tire's digging in here. So this is another good spot that I have found that wants to push the rig down instead of pull itself up. So I've got another good spot here, guys, that is proving to be. Get back in there. I want to get in that hole. And oh, it almost had it. That was almost it, guys. Or gals, I keep saying guys. To all my female viewers, oh, there it is. I apologize. I am in no way a misogynist. I just assume that from my wife's perspective, not too many women are into this. So if you're happening to be a female when you're watching, hey, I absolutely love the fact that you're here watching my videos. If not, get back in that kitchen. I'm just kidding. Couldn't help myself. Oh, come on. Look at this. Finally, found a hard spot. This is pretty up and down, guys. And this may be something that I may have to really practice at. I've got rocks I can set there, but I really don't want to. But I think it's a matter of angle. I think my approach angle is wrong. Because it's wanting to slide towards me, and that's kind of what I need to try to avoid. Plus, I got a bunch of pea gravel. I'm sure you guys can see that under all the leaves. So that pea gravel, you can see it's digging a hole in that pea gravel, which again is what I wanted. I'm trying to increase my difficulty here while I'm resisting the urge to rock out to my Boston here. I am 43, so most of the music that I'm going to be listening to is not going to be Cardi B. I really disdain newer music for the most part. I'm a 60s, 70s, 80s. Don't get me wrong, I do like my 50s, but I gotta say the boomers had the best music. When my dad was in high school, Led Zeppelin was releasing new albums, and he somehow conned his dad into buying him a Plymouth Roadrunner. And if you guys are familiar with that vehicle, what it must have been like to be a teenager listening to the new Zeppelin album on an 8-track in the front bench seat of your Plymouth Roadrunner. Yeah, my dad wasn't spoiled at all. Pretty sweet deal. But I'll take Fox Body Mustang listening to Nirvana. Would love to have that car back. And oddly enough, guys, for a very short time, I was in between vehicles. And I was driving my mom's Mazda Miata, which is about as girly as it gets if you ask me. But that little thing was fun. It would scoot. For as lightweight, I guess, as it is, 130 horsepower doesn't really have to be a problem. But what a fun little car that was. And now I've been driving SUVs ever since. Oh, I thought I had it that time. But I gotta say, I've been driving an FJ Cruiser for the past, I bought it in 2006 when they first came out. And I'm still driving it. And I've put on alternator on it, I think. So really, really nice vehicles, guys. Gotta love that Toyota reliability. I love my tacos.